chairman, principal, teachers, and of course, our lovely graduates. The Lord be with you. We'll begin with the singing of the national, the playing of the national anthem. I invite our parents who are sitting, could you kindly stand?
Eternal Father, bless our land. Guide us with thy mighty hand. Keep us free from evil powers. Be our life through countless hours. To our leaders, great defenders, grant true wisdom from above. Justice, truth be ours for. Lord, you are spirit. Prepare us in mind and spirit and tune our hearts to sing your praise. The song, You Made a Way.
Together in the presence of Almighty God and the whole company of heaven to offer to him through our Lord Jesus Christ our worship, praise, and our thanksgiving. To give thanks for all the benefits and opportunities for the past years. We especially thank him for the light he shone upon those, our children, who are about to graduate from this place of learning. We pray, Father, that you grant those things that are needful for both body and soul. Therefore, let us silently remember God's presence with us now. Let us acknowledge before God our shortcomings and errors. O God, our Father, we confess before you our many failings, our lack of faith in you and in ourselves, our lack of response to the many opportunities given to us, our reluctance to accept the many challenges of life. Deliver us from acts of thoughtlessness and deeds that may hurt others and ourselves. Make us always willing to do your will, now and always. Amen. Father of mercy, Father of grace, Father who love us and have journeyed with us these many years, we come now, Father, in thanksgiving as a family, as parents, as guardians, as teachers, as ancillary staff, as board of management. And we come, Lord, to acknowledge your goodness to us. Thank you, Lord, that you have journeyed with us, especially in this time of pandemic. Thank you, Lord, that you made the way. Thank you, Lord, that you constantly stay by our sides. We thank you, Lord, that your promise to us is that you will never leave us, nor will you forsake us. So, Lord, as we come now this afternoon in thanksgiving, in praise, because you made the way, we pray, God, that we will be sensitive and responsive to you. And as your children leave this institution, Lord, we know that you will not leave them, but you will journey with them. Bless us now, Lord, as we look to you. As we celebrate their success, we tell you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Please sit.
A reading from the Word of God, as it is written in Psalm 119, beginning at verse 105. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. I have sworn an oath and confirmed it, to observe your righteous ordinances. I am severely afflicted. Give me life, O Lord, according to your word. Accept my offerings of praise, O Lord, and teach me your ordinances. I hold my life in my hand continually, but do not forget your law. The wicked have laid a snare for me, but I do not share precepts. Your forever to the end. This is the word of the Lord.
We stand for the hymn, "The Lord I'll Not Want." And that year we know we are speaking about who? We are speaking about God. And God has been with you through these many years. 6 years, is it? Or five for those who may have come into Glenmuir Prep School later. And I want to say to you, graduates or graduands, that God has been with you. God has been guiding you. And I know as you move from Glenmuir Preparatory School to the high school that you will be going to, all sorts of things may be going through your minds, especially if you find out that your best friend is not there with you. And when you look around in a strange classroom and you notice that you're not sure about the teachers, you're not sure about who will become your friend, I want you to remember who you are. You are special. You are important. So one of the first things that I want you to remember is, first and foremost, is to respect yourself. Respect yourself. Know that you are special. Know that you are not just anybody. And when you respect yourself, you know what is going to be happening? Other persons will look to you, and they will come to respect you. Of course, there are other students who may be better at a particular subject, but I'm saying to you that you respect yourself and ensure that nobody looks down on you. As you respect yourself, your classmates will respect you, your teachers will respect you. And you know something? When you go home and the way you're acting, your parents themselves will start to think, say, hey, my son is certainly maturing. And they too, even more than they are doing right now. And you know something? That respect, are respecting yourself. Sooner or later, you will. And I know you will respect your teachers and your classmates. You're going to high school, and that is heavy responsibility on your small shoulders. Responsibility, a big word, but guess what? Because you are growing and you are maturing, you are going to recognize I have to take responsibility for myself. And you know something, not only yourself, because I'm sure that I'm going to be here in our scene, that some of you are prefects, that some of you may be a head boy, a head girl at your school. But you have been or you're behaving in a responsible way. It seems like a lot is being put on you. But guess what? You can do it. All the potential, you have it within you to do well, to be responsible for your actions, whatever you do. You have to take responsibility for your actions. And you have to be fair. You know, sometimes there are students who can be difficult. And sometimes you have to say, no, you were wrong. And you don't have to be afraid. You respect others. They are going to think twice about what they say or what they will do to you. So, and then I remember, you know that I have said it to you already, let no one despise you because of your youth, but be an example to the others. Be an example, because you know something, students, sometimes when persons do something that is wrong and they know that they were wrong, they may not say it to you, but truly sometimes in the quiet moments of the night and when they reflect, they will recognize that what you were saying, what you were doing, you were only doing it for their good. And some may not come back and say, no, I'm sorry, you are right, but guess what? God sees, God knows, and God will reward you. God sees, and God knows, and God will reward you. And the last thing that I want to say to you, be caring. Be caring. You love yourselves, and most of us, we love ourselves first, not true? And we want the best for ourselves. But guess what? We have to be sensitive and responsive to others. There are some students who will come to school, and in this time of COVID, many of them will not have a gadget. Many of them will not come to school as you are present at school. And guess what? You have to be caring enough to pick up the phone and call your friends and say, what happened? Encourage them. Share with them what you learned in the day. We have to be caring because that is why God created us. He created us so that we can share and we can care for each other. And you know what? When you do that, God will continue to bless you. Not that he's not blessing the others, but you will be a role model for many. So as you go from here to your various schools, remember that God is with you. He is your light. He will guide you. Part of the psalm that was read said that your life is in your hand. But guess what? When you remember that God is always be praying for you. And if you come to Glenmuir, always be praying for you. And if you come to Glenmuir High School, don't be afraid to call me, to speak to me. If you have anything that is bothering you, I'm there for you. So God bless you as you journey on, as you go to a higher height. Right? We are going to be praying our prayer of intercession, and it's in your program. And I'm going to invite you to stand, students. And you will see the responses that you will have to make. Let us pray. Faithful God, in and through your Son, Jesus Christ, we honor and celebrate you today in this our school leaving ceremony. You have been there for us day after day, year after year. We thank you for your guidance, inspiration, provision, care, and protection. You have kept your hand upon us, and your grace and mercy have brought us to this significant occasion. We praise and thank you. We thank you for the Anglican Church in Jamaica and the Cayman Islands, especially the Cure of St. Gabriel's Maypen, for providing the guidance, encouragement, and spiritual support since the founding of this noble institution. Praise. We thank you for our principals whose leadership and dedication bear witness of their obedience to their calling, their dependency on you, and their faith in you, which enabled the school to be a beacon. We thank you for the Board of Management, the Ministry of Education, the Jamaica Independent Schools Association, the Parent Teachers Association, the administrative and support staff, and all stakeholders whose generous support assists us in providing the way best for our students over these years. Father, you are the fountain of wisdom and knowledge. We thank you for our teachers, for the gifts and talents you have bestowed on them. Continue to enlighten them by your Spirit, so that as they do their work, those entrusted to their care may come to know you and rejoice in the knowledge of your truth. We pray that as they grow in maturity, they may come to know, worship, and serve you for generations to come. We thank you for every child who is a student here. And we commit to your continued care those who are about to leave us at this time. May they be ever mindful that they belong to you, Lord, and that they can do all things in and through you. Lord, hear our prayer. May the lives of those who are associated with this institution reflect your faithfulness and your glory. May we never fail to bring honor and praise to your name. Amen. Dana and Jaden. And graduates, you are going to be led in the prayer. So you are going to be led. So we all, you're all going to say it together.
Father, you have guided and blessed us thus far. We praise and thank you.
As we open our hearts to deeper thinking, learning, and sharing, be with us, Father.
As we claim new horizons, we will keep our hands in yours, Father.
Your word will be forever. Be our lamp to guide and light our way.
Your word will be forever in our lamp to guide and light our way. May our lives forever praise you, now and always. Amen.
Okay, the graduates will pray the school prayer together. 1, 2, 3, go. Right. Together we say the family prayer, the Lord's Prayer. Everybody. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, ever and ever. Amen. Merciful God, to you we commend ourselves, especially your children. Lord, we pray that you will continue to lead and guide them. Lord, when they need your help and correction, we pray, gracious God, that they will remember that you are their light, you are their source. And so may the strength of God pilot us. May the power of God preserve us. May the wisdom of God instruct us. May the hand of God protect us. May the way of God direct us. May the shield of God defend us. May the host of God guard us against the snares of evil and the temptations of the world. May Christ be with us, Christ before us, Christ in us, Christ over us. May your salvation, O Lord, be always ours, this day and forevermore. Amen. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
I know we're not at school or devotion, but what are you to say? Wow, it's not devotion, but okay.
You are very, very welcome.
Thank you, Sister Jane. Okay, graduates, good afternoon once again to our graduates, teachers, parents, and well-wishers. We are now on to part two of our program, and I'll be introducing to you our school's board chairman, Mrs. Emma D. Thomas, Justice of the Peace. She is our chairman, and she assumed that responsibility in August 2020. Let's make Mrs. Thomas welcome. Give her a round of applause. You may be seated. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Riley. Sister Alvarine Roberts, chaplain of Glenmuir Preparatory School, members of Glenmuir Prep School Board, Mr. Barrington Richardson, our regional director from the Ministry of Education, if you are out there in virtual space with us, Principal Andre Riley, honored members of the graduating class of 2021, members of the academic, administrative, and ancillary staff, Mrs. Sasha Samuels, president of the Parent Teachers Association, parents, guardians, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, on behalf of the Board of Management, I extend a cordial welcome to everyone. For the second year, we gather against the backdrop of the coronavirus pandemic to celebrate the graduation of Glenmuir Prep School newest grade 6 class. Today's graduation exercise, a drive-through exercise being streamed, necessitated by COVID-19. Our 29 grade 6 students who will be graduating today deserve our highest commendations. Without a doubt, members of our graduating class have applied themselves. They have worked and studied hard and have overcome the challenges to the learning process posed by the pandemic in order to successfully complete the primary exit profile PEP exams. Congratulations, graduates. You have been triumphant in your final year here at Glenmuir Prep. And I know you are eagerly looking forward to entering high school. Ladies and gentlemen, students, even as I congratulate our 2021 graduates, I must recognize the role played by all the Glenmuir Prep stakeholders for the part in creating the environment to ensure the success of this graduating class. In this regard, I'm pleased to commend the following stakeholders for having implemented policies and strategies to ensure the school's responsiveness to the education challenges posed by the pandemic. I therefore thank members of the board for the support given. Principal Andre Riley and his team of academic, administrative, and ancillary staff. Sister Alvarine Roberts, our chaplain. The teachers, those who have worked with the graduating class over the past 6 years. Special mention must be made of Miss Beverly Campbell and Mrs. Janet Duncan-Williams, our current grade 6 teachers. The parents and guardians of the grade 6 students, for their work over the past year in helping to prepare the 2021 graduating class. Of course, our Parent Teachers Association, headed by Sasha Samuels, and all members of that group. We must commend them. We commend them on their recent virtual concert held last Friday. Of course, the Diocesan Board of Education, we must thank them. Representatives from the Ministry of Education and past students, and we want to use this medium to appeal to past students of Glenmuir Prep School to ask what you can do for your school as you seek to give back. And I really must say thanks to past students, Andre Thomas, Dr. Lisa Gay Thomas, and Dr. Tashni Ann DeBroy for their donations to this school. I must also thank the members from the wider Maypen community for the support that they have given to the prep school. In particular, though, I commend Principal Riley, who was proactive and vigilant, focused as he guided Glenmuir Prep through the various modifications necessitated by the pandemic. Yes, you may clap. These include online lessons and face-to-face classes while ensuring strict adherence to the DRMA protocols in order to guarantee the safety of the school population. Graduands, I again commend you heartily for having completed this phase of your education under the unusual circumstances of the coronavirus pandemic. I know you are looking forward to high school, new experiences, and meeting new friends. In all this excitement, please remember to pay keen attention and stay engaged during your classes, particularly since you will be having different teachers for each subject. Graduands, you will need to take personal responsibility for yourselves, the things you do or did not do. Please do not cultivate the habit of making excuses like, I did not do my homework because teacher, mommy, daddy, grandma, or my friend did not. You need to take responsibility for yourself or of yourself. You need to find a way to get to your schoolwork done and done on time. You will make new friends at high school. As you select your friends, please ensure that they are positive and forward-thinking individuals. Individuals who believe in the words, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Individuals who will help you to grow and excel on your journey to get a solid education. Please cultivate a great appetite for knowledge. Don't wait on your teachers to tell you everything. Do your research. And conducting research is so very easy now, compared to 5, 15, 25, 30 years ago. Mr. Google is just a click away. Go ahead of your teachers and do your readings on topics on your syllabi so you can ask questions in your class. Yes, graduands, ask questions in your class. Be confident and bold. That's one of the ways you will learn. Importantly, my friends, put your very best effort in everything you do. In the process, you will discover that you are what you are good at. And this perhaps could lead you to whatever profession you will eventually pursue. I'm sure some of you have already decided what career you want to pursue. If you haven't, no problem at all, because you have time to make that decision. As you enter high school, I'm confident that you will take with you the values you've learned here at Glenmuir Prep School. This will mean always striving for excellence, developing your skills and talents, and above all, preparing yourselves to be good citizens for a better future, as articulated by your school's mission. Graduands, yours will be a journey of discovery and perhaps even exhilaration as you engage in new knowledge and a fresh understanding of the world. I'm confident that based on the foundation laid here at Glenmuir Prep, each of you has the capacity to make a difference in whatever way you choose. Finally, I want to say to you that others, maybe your friends, for example, may disagree with you. You need to respect and accept that. Some may be hostile and try to pick a fight with you, and you may be tempted to fight back. I encourage you to talk through your disagreements and conflicts in a calm and peaceful manner. Try at all times to avoid situations that could hurt yourself as well as others. Graduands, remember that all of us and each of you here, each graduand, is a part of that group that really has a great maker. And Sister Jem spoke about our great maker, our God and Heavenly Father, who hears us when we pray. He's the one who said, suffer the little children to come unto me. He says we need to believe, to have faith, to do our work, and to pray. I recommend this as a good strategy to employ as you seek to do well in school. Believe in yourselves, graduands. Believe in yourselves. You are made in the image of God. You can achieve what you truly believe. Be Christ-like in all you do. Be kind, helpful, obedient, and loving. And as the golden rule says, do unto others as you would want them to do to you. You are coming from a school that is set on a hill. Let me say that again. You are coming from a school that is set on a hill. Jamaica's future awaits every one of you. God's richest blessings on your journey.
Thank you very much, Chairman. Graduates, please stand. We're going to recess to the outside, and that is where we're going to have our handing over and our graduation. But before you go, maybe this is for the last time that you'll ever say or do this, so we have to cheer so that our neighbors in Maypen can hear us. Glenmuir Prep School is? Glenmuir Prep School is? Glenmuir Prep School is? Very good. Technician.
Don't know how, but you did it. Made a way. Standing here. Not knowing how we'll get through this test. But holding on to faith, you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this figured out, and you're watching us now. And when it looks as if we can't win, wrap us in your arms and step in. And everything we need you to supply. You got this in control, and now we know that you made a way. When our backs were
against the wall, and it looked as if it was over,
Lord, you made a way. And we're standing
afternoon, everyone. We're now presenting our school leavers. Here comes Kyle Dillon Abrahams. He receives his school leaving certificate. Outstanding work was done by Kyle in mathematics. He's a member of the table tennis team and a member of the chess team.
With the relatives of Kyle, if you so choose, you can go to center stage with him now to take a picture. So all the persons that are here with Kyle, you can go to center stage, the chairman will step aside, and you go to center stage and you can take a picture, if you so choose. Very good breath.
I present Janine Anderson. Janine receives her school leaving certificate. She has done outstanding work in language arts. She's a member of the culture club. Janine Anderson.
Parents of Janine, you may join her center stage. Thank you.
presenting Alejandra Bennett. Alejandra is receiving a school leaving certificate. She is also a class monitor.
Family, you may go. Bennett. Kyle receives his school leaving certificate. He is our head boy, was a prefect, a member of the football team, the tennis team, and the quiz team. Kyle is one of the top spellers in the group, and he's a top boy performer. Family, you may join Kyle. Thank you.
Presenting Tiana Britton. Tiana receives her school leaving certificate. She is our head girl. She was a prefect. She's a member of the netball team, the track and field team, and the quiz team. Tiana is our top girl performer.
Presenting Zaire Brown. Zaire is receiving a school leaving certificate. Zaire was a member of the football team, member of the table tennis, and member of the cricket team. Presenting Garrett Bryan. Garrett is receiving a school leaving certificate. Garrett has been a prefect, and he's also a member of the chess team. Present Aidan Bunting. Aidan receives a school leaving certificate in the category of outstanding academic performance. He was a prefect and a member of the football team. Thank you.
representing Jordan Dixon. Jordan receives her school leaving certificate in the category of academic achievement. She was a class monitor and a member of the Brownies Club. Jordan Dixon. Zoli is receiving her school leaving certificate in the category of academic achievement. She was a prefect, a member of the quiz team and the gymnastic team. Zoli Duffus.
Daniel Dunkley is receiving his school leaving certificate. Daniel was a prefect, member of the football team, member of the track and field team, member of the Cub Scouts, member of the spelling bee, and the quiz team. Thank you.
Jaden receives his school leaving certificate in the category of academic achievement. He is our deputy head boy. He was a prefect, a member of the football team, a member of the cricket team, a member of the track and field team, a member of the Cub Scouts, a member of the Spelling Bee Club, a member of the quiz team, and there is an award that's shared between Jaden and someone else. Jaden is he is the most involved scholar.
Presenting the Maori folks.
The Maori is receiving a school leaving certificate. The Maori is currently a prefect, member of the football team, and also a member of the Club Scouts. The Maori is a top speller. Thank you.
representing Kaori Green. Kaori receives her school leaving certificate. She has done outstanding work in language arts. She was a member of the gymnastic team. Kaori Green.
Receiving her school leaving certificate, Amalia joined us in grade 6. She has worked very hard to achieve this high standard of work. Amalia. Thank you. receiving her school leaving certificate. She's a member of the gymnastic team. She's also a member of the netball team. Shakal Medley is receiving a school leaving certificate. He's a member of the football team, a very good member. He's a member of the track and field team and a member of the tennis team.
Thank you.
presenting Shakira Matthews. Shakira is receiving a school leaving certificate. She's a member of the gymnastic team, and she's also a member of the netball team. Shakira Matthews. Diana Gail Rose. Diana is receiving a school leaving certificate. Diana is a prefect. She's most aware scholar. She's a member of the Brownies Club. She's also a member of the Environment Club and a member of the Gymnastic Club. Thank you.
presenting Amelia Singh. Amelia receives her school leaving certificate in the category of Outstanding Academic Performance. She is our deputy head girl. She was a prefect, a member of the Environmental Club, the Brownies Club, the Gymnastic Club, the Dance Troupe, the Spelling Bee Club, the Swimming Club, the Netball Team, and the Quiz Team. Not finished for Amelia. Amelia is one of our top spellers. Amelia shares the Chad Anson Award for the most involved student with Jaden Ferron. Amelia Singh.
Tariq Stalls. Tariq is receiving a school leaving certificate. Tariq is the most helpful scholar in grade 5 and 6. He's a member of the football club, he's a member of the cricket team, and he's also a member of the track and field team. Tariq Stalls. Thank you.
presenting Josh Virtue. Josh receives his school leaving certificate. Josh is a prefect, a member of the football team, a member of the track and fields team, a member of the Cub Scouts, a member of the karate team. Josh is also one of our top spellers.
Presenting Ariana Watson. She's receiving a school leaving certificate. She is the most improved student. She is a member of the swimming team and a member of the gymnastics team. Ariana Watson. Thank you. Presenting London Williams. London Williams. London is receiving a school leaving certificate. London is a member of the football team. He's a member of the Cub Scout, and he's also a member of the table tennis team. London Williams.
Well, London is the only one. Well, London is exiting. Congratulations to you, London. The others are gone. Colleagues, friends, we're at the end. And I timed it exact. I did say 6 o'clock. It is now 6 o'clock. I want to thank the chairman of the school board, Mrs. Emma Thomas, members of staff, family, friends, graduates, congratulations. And we are at the end. Thank you very much for joining us. Hopefully next year. Thank you to our announcers and grade six teachers. Let's give them a round of applause, Mrs. Duncan Williamson and Miss Campbell. Thank you very much. Graduation 2021. We don't know what 2022 will look like, but we will see. God's willing. Thank you to our presenters, Ms. Bolar and Ms. Sims. They always do a good job at that. I could never do that. And thank you to Mrs. Langley and Ms. Watt for receiving the caps and the gowns. Thank you also to our technical team, the Thompsons, the Tomlinsons. I ran to turn on the light and Mr. Tomlinson said, no, he's not ready for that as yet. So I want to thank the team who has been here since about 1 o'clock. So thank you all for coming, and I want to wish you a safe journey home. Thank you very much. That's it for us. That's a wrap. Thank you.